So today's topic is water resources index. We study introduction, water uses and over exploitation. Third, flood, drought, traditional water management system, big dam benefits and its problem. So what is water resources? Water is an intangible natural resource on this earth on which all life depends. Although water is very abundant on this earth, yet is very precious. Most of total water reserve of the world, about 97% is a salty water, and most of the animal and plant have 60 to 65% in their body. Only 3% is a fresh water. Even this small fraction of fresh water is not available to us, as most of it is locked up in a polar ice caps, and just 0.03% is readily available to us in the form of groundwater and surface water. Water is characterized by certain unique features which make it a marvelous resource. It acts as a liquid over a wide range of a temperature, that is from 0 degree to 100 degrees Celsius. Second, it has a high specific heat due to which it warms up and cools down very slowly without constant shock of temperature jerk to the aquatic life. And it has a high latent heat of evaporation, hence it takes a huge amount of energy for getting evaporized. That's why it produces a cooling effect as it evaporates. It is an excellent solvent for several nutrients. Thus it can serve as a very good carrier for nutrients, including oxygen, which is essential for life. But it can be easily dissolve various pollutants and become a carrier of pathogenic microorganisms. Water uses and over-exploitation. Due to its unique property, water is of multiple use for all the living organisms. Water is absolutely essential for life. Most of life processes takes place in water contained in the body. Uptake of nutrients, their distribution in the body, regulation of temperature, and removal of waste from all the medicant through water. Activity. Water is used for drinking, irrigation, transportation, washing, and water disposed for industry and used as a coolant for thermal power plant. Water shapes the earth's surface and regulates our temperature, climate. And next is groundwater. About 9.86 of total fresh water resources is in the form of the groundwater, and it is about 35 to 50 times of the surface water supply. Till some time back, groundwater was considered to be very pure. However, of late, even groundwater aquifer has been found to be contaminated. A layer of sediment or a rock that is highly permeable and contain water is called an aquifer. Aquifer is maybe of two type: confined aquifer, which is overlaid by permeable earth membrane, earth material, and they are recharged by water seeping down from above in the form of the waterfall or rainfall and snowmelt. Confined aquifer, which is sandwiched between two impermeable layers of rock and sediment, and are recharged only those areas where the aquifer intersect the land surface. Sometimes the recharge area is hundreds of kilometers away from the location of well. Effects of groundwater usage subsides. When the groundwater withdrawal is more than its recharge rate, the sediment in the aquifer get compact, a phenomena known as a ground subside. A huge economic loss may occur due to its phenomena because it result in a sinking of overlying land surface. The common problem associated with it is include structure damage in buildings, fracture in pipes, reserving the layer of sewers and canals, and tidal flooding, lowering of water table. Mining of groundwater is done extensively in grid and semi-grid region or for irrigating crop field. However, it is not advisable to be excessive mining as it would cause a sharp decline in future agriculture production due to lowering of water table. Water lodging. When excessive irrigation is done with a brackish water, it rises the water table, gradually leading to a water logging and sanding problem. Flood. Heavy waterfall often cause flood in the low-lying coastal areas. Prolonged downpour can also cause the overflowing of lakes and rivers, resulting into flood. Deforestation, overgrazing, mining, rapid industrialization, global warming, etc. also have contributed largely to a sharp rise in the incidence of floods, which otherwise is a natural disaster. Droughts. When annual rainfall is below normal and less than evaporation, drought condition is created. Ironically, these drought hit areas are often having a high population growth, which leads to poor land uses and make the situation worse. Anthropogenic causes. Drought is a meteorological phenomena, but due to several anthropogenic causes like overgrazing, deforestation, mining, etc., these are spreading of desert, tending to convert more areas to drought affected areas. Erroneous and intensive cropping pattern and increasing the exploitation of scarce water resources through the well and canal irrigation to get a high productivity has converted a drought prone area to a desified area once. So next is sustainable measures. Indigenous knowledge in control of drought and desertification can be useful for dealing with the problem. Carefully selected mixed cropping help optimize production and minimize the risk of the crop failure. Next, social, forestry and wasteland development can provide quite effective to fight against the problem, but it should be based on proper understanding of ecological requirement and natural processes. Traditional water management system. In India, even today, there are several villages where water management is done not by the irrigation department, but by the local managers. So in South India, Anaini County manages the traditional tanks very effectively, efficiently, based on his or her knowledge of the drainage and irrigation needs. They usually give preference to the tail and fields and decide per capita allocation of water based on the stock of available water in the tank and crop needs. In Maharashtra, the water managers are called Havaldars, and who manages and resolve the conflicts by overseeing the water channels from the main canal to the distributed canals. So the main source of water is melt water from glaciers and snow, supplementary by water from spring and marshes. The water is distributed to the different fields through an integrated networks of earthen channel. Big dam benefits and problems. Benefits: river well project and river well project with a big dams have usually been considered to play a key role in the development process due to its multiple uses. India has a distinction of having a large number of river valley projects. So the dams are often regarded as a symbol of national development. The tribal living in the area pinned big hopes on these projects, had they aimed at providing employment and rising the standard and the quality of life. The dams have tremendous potential for economic upliftment and growth. They can help in checking floods and fames, generating electricity and reduce water and power shortage, provide irrigation water to the lower areas, provide drinking water in a remote area, and provide navigation and fishery, etc. So next is environmental process. The environment impacts of big dams are also too many, due to which very often the big dams become a subject of controversy. The impact can be at the upstream as well as the downstream level. So first is downstream impact, including the following: the waterlogging and salinity due to over-irrigation, microclimate change, reduce the water flow and silt deposition in river, flash flood, salt water intrusion at river mouth, loss of land fertility along the river since the sediment carrying nutrients get deposited in the reservoir, outbreak of the vector-borne diseases like malaria. Second is the upstream problem, including the following: displacement of the tribal people, loss of forest flora and fauna, change in fishery and the flowing ground, siltation and sedimentation of the reservoir, loss of non-forest land, segregation and water logging near reservoir, breeding of vector and spread of vector-borne diseases, reservoir-induced seismicity causing earthquake, growth of aquatic weeds, microclimate change. So this is all about water resources.